right, our normal everyday warm up. So we're gonna breathe in for 5 seconds. 1, 2, 3.
William,
four,
no chatting.
5, and breathe out. 2, 3, 4, 5. Breathe in.
Turn up your volume.
And breathe out. Breathe in. And breathe out. Okay, remember we're doing that breathing the whole time. Okay.
Okay.
Don't do that. So arms come up overhead. And we're gonna slowly bend to the right side. All the way down. By the end of this, we're gonna be able to like touch the ground. Bend all the way over. We're getting a little better every time we do it. Okay, come back up to center. Reach back up as high as you can, elongate your spine. And then come to the left side. Remember to breathe. And come back up. And now we're gonna come forward and touch our toes or go down as far as we can. Okay, kind of bend both of our legs left and right. Your ankles and knees all warmed up. Okay, then we're gonna grab our legs behind our ankles and kind of pull down as far as we can go. Twisted. All right, the next one I'm gonna do from the side so you guys can actually see what's going on. Okay, so this one's called down dog. All we're gonna do is put our hands out in front of us and keep our legs down.
Okay, reminder everybody, we are not supposed to be chatting during this. We can ask questions afterwards.
Yes, questions are for after. Right now we're just gonna do it the best that we can, and then we can ask questions after, okay?
You see me, I'm falling all the time, so it's okay if you fall.
Totally okay.
William, no more, okay? Let's go, no more chatting, folks.
Okay, so we're just up like this. This is called downward facing dog. Okay, we're just gonna hold that for a little bit. And then we're gonna bring our right leg up. And just hold that. And now we're gonna do kind of what we did yesterday, where we bring our leg through. It's like the crossbody mountain climber. So we're just gonna bring our right leg to our left elbow. So we're just gonna bring it through and touch and come back. And bring it through and come back. And bring it through one more time. And come back. And now our leg is coming back down, back into downward facing dog, kind of reposition. And we're gonna do the other side. Okay, ready? Bring your leg back and hold it. We're just gonna hold. And now we're gonna bring it in towards our elbow. So opposite elbow. Bring it in, bring it back out. Hold, bring it in, and bring it back out. Bring it back out, and back into downward facing dog. Okay, good. Now let's walk our hands all the way back up until we're standing. Okay, good. Now we're going to go down to the ground, and our legs are going to come out, and we're just going to come out as far as we can. Yeah, we both are not very good at this one. So anyone who has their splits already can probably come all the way down to the ground.
And some people are definitely more flexible than us.
I'm not flexible like that.
But it does feel good.
It does, yes. Just kind of reach out as far as you can. Remember the breathing technique where we breathe in. And then when we breathe out, we push a little bit further. That's going to help us really get in deeper into our stretches. Okay, good. Come back up. Come back up.
Sorry, I like
come
that
back
one.
Up. Okay, so the next one is called pigeon. We're going to bring our leg out in front of us, like so. Let me back up. So we're going to bring our left leg up and kind of pull it out in front of us. And our right leg goes back. And then we're just going to walk ourselves down as far as we can. This is really going to stretch out our hips, which we don't really get to stretch ever. So go down as far as you can, as far as it feels comfortable.
Miss Mullen will be taking me out of this position.
And if you want, you can walk a little bit further and try and get all the way down. That will really get you into that stretch. And we're gonna hold. Okay, good, and come back up. And then we're gonna switch our legs. So we come back up. Now our right leg is gonna come out in front of us. Left leg is going to go back, and then we're just going to kind of melt down to the ground.
Good terminology.
Go as far down as you can. And this one kind of does hurt a little bit. It shouldn't be painful, but you should really feel that stretch in like areas where you don't normally feel stretching. So, because we never really stretch our hips out. We never really stretch that muscle out. So this is a good way to get that muscle stretched. But again, we never want to feel pain. We can feel some pulling, but we never want to feel pain. Walk it out a little bit further if we can. Okay, come back up. And out. Good. Okay, next one we're gonna do is just a simple bridge. We're gonna lay on our backs and we're gonna push up like so. So we're not gonna go all the way into a back bridge. You can if you want, I guess, but we really just wanna stay like this.
And don't push with the hands, just allow the body to move.
Exactly. So we're letting our like midsection make an arc instead of pushing up with our hands. We really just want that to be a natural arc. Remember to breathe. Okay, good. Come back up.
Oh boy.
And that's all I got for you guys today.
All right. Thank you, Miss Mullen.